Waterman.
Hi, John Waterman, J-O-H-N-Q-U-A-R-T-E-R-M-A-N. Hasn't changed since the last two times I spoke. I'm president of the Walls Watershed Coalition, sort of banner hanging over there. That's for Withlacoochee, Willacoochee, Alapaha Little, and Upper Suwannee River. That banner is old, it doesn't have Suwannee, but we have a new one. And, well, first of all, do y'all feel insignificant yet? Because that's what FERC's DIS tells us, we're all insignificant. But Walls didn't feel insignificant, because when the Florida Department of Environmental Protection decided, it posted in the newspapers a notice of intent to issue a permit for Sable Trail to drill under the Suwannee River and otherwise use wetlands and submerged lands of the sovereign state of Florida. Now, we filed a petition to oppose that, and DEP said, oh, you didn't do that quite right. So we amended it and sent it back. Then something happened that everyone told us would never, ever happen. Because everyone who ever dealt with DEP on a thing like this said, you'll never even get a hearing. And, you know, frankly, I believe them. I even misread the first response. I thought that's what it said. It wasn't. We got a hearing. Now, this hearing is currently scheduled for the 19th through the 22nd of October in Jasper, or in Wide Oak if they can't get the courtroom in Jasper. There is some possibility the judge may decide to move it up, because Sable Trail is asking for a summary hearing, which the judge has already said you can have that, unless we can come up with a better argument, why not? And Sable Trail is also trying to quash all sorts of evidence. All these safety issues you've heard about, and there are far, far more. For example, that $50 million record EPA fine, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania fined Spectra $18 million for those same PCB spills and made them pay $200 million in cleanups. And I've heard industry reps make excuses about Spectra's Edison, New Jersey apartment fire, which made thousands of people evacuate and hundreds homeless. And you know, I could keep talking about a whole bunch of those, but the point is, Spectra doesn't want us to talk about those. Now, they say that safety is solely a federal matter. Be that as it may, there may be other reasons to bring up these issues, but Spectra definitely doesn't want us to. Spectra also doesn't want us to talk about the risk of terrorism to the pipeline. What better target than a 500-mile-long improvised explosive device? And in lots of other countries in the Middle East, in Colombia, they are targets, as evidenced in many reports. And I dug up a report which I read from yesterday that, meanwhile, if you've looked at any of the FERC documents that have been filed with from Sable Trail, you notice that a lot of them say CEII, which is Critical Energy Infrastructure Information. When FERC promulgated that rule in 2003 in the aftermath of 9/11, the text of their rule said it was about terrorism. So on the one hand, you have Sable Trail saying in the DEP proceeding that terrorism is merely speculative, you can't talk about that. Yet they're hiding behind a FERC rule which was explicitly for terrorism. In both cases, they're trying to suppress information about their pipeline. If their pipeline is so great, why are they trying to suppress all this information? Now, I do want to say just one word about the significance of this case, which is, as an example of why Sable Trail, I think they take it seriously, they have four high-paid lawyers on their side. DEP had their chief attorney, now they've added another one. That's six attorneys facing our tiny little non-attorney pro se operation. You've seen all three of those right here. So why are they piling on all those attorneys? Because they know, without that permit, the pipeline can't cross the Suwannee River. If it can't cross the Suwannee River, every one of Sable Trail's routes that it's proposed, preferred, alternate, whatever, every one of them would cross the Suwannee River. So if we win this case, that's a pipeline. Now, there's other ways to win, but I bring this up because a lot of people think it's a done deal, it's a juggernaut, there's nothing you can do to stop it. There are ways to stop it. This is one of the ways. The things that are being brought up about that compressor station and about the compressor station in Albany, Georgia, those are other ways. And there's an Army Corps of Engineer process going on right now where you have until October 11th to file comments or to ask for a public hearing. We can stop this pipeline. If even Shell Oil give up on drilling in the Arctic after wasting $7 billion, Sable Trail can be stopped, and we can stop it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Corbin. Number 14, Mr. Harry Peterson. Patterson, excuse me.